Welcome back. Anth, you'll have found that a little bit difficult interviewing everybody, bearing in mind you weren't there.
Yeah, I mean, it's one of the hardest ones I've actually had to do, even though we've got probably the most information we've ever had. It's something that we're not really wanting to do on the show. You know, we don't want to be digging people out here. But yeah, it's interesting, especially with us not being there. You know, you were there yourself. It probably would have been better if you had interviewed. But we've got to be impartial, haven't we?
We have, and unfortunately, because it's only a 30-minute show, some of these interviews have had to have been cut down. So hopefully, we've picked the correct snippets out.
Going on to other things now, obviously something we've spoke to Nick about, the manager and Morpeth. Your reaction to what happened on Saturday, obviously through the game, and then afterwards, obviously during the game, did you get the feeling that it was going to kick off like that?
I think with the way Newton Aycliffe have played, they're always on the edge. From tackles wise, from the way they go on the bench, from behind the bench, it's always going to be a hostile atmosphere. I didn't think of what happened on Saturday would have happened, but it's probably one of the worst things I've seen in football after a game.
So, after the games played, can you tell us a little bit about what actually did happen?
What I remember, I was walking in with Doninger. Somebody's fired a ball at us. It's missed us, and then one of their players charged for Doninger. I stepped in and held him back. Then just a big melee basically happened, and then we got pushed into our dressing room, and then there was about 20 people trying to get in to hit us in the dressing room.
And what stage was this broke up?
It went on for a good 4 or 5 minutes. The only thing that probably stopped it was their assistant manager, I think it's Fez. Bedlington, he stepped in and stopped them from getting into the dressing room and chucked them all away. And I think if it wasn't for him, it could have turned proper nasty.
So obviously this has happened. The lads would presumably be a bit shook up in the dressing room, and then you've just tried to get away, obviously as quick as possible.
Yeah, but obviously normally you go into the bar and have a drink and obviously food after the hospitality from the away team. But I think everybody connected with the club just wanted to get away from the ground. We all thought we left together, but obviously we didn't, because later on one of the lads got jumped on the way out.
And are you all right now? Have you got anything from them?
Yeah, there was I think two or three of the lads coming out with one of the parents and grandma. One of the lads got jumped on and the grandma got knocked over, which shouldn't be seen in football. I think the chairman witnessed it. What's happened, obviously, and I think that's what's happened afterwards with the reaction of their manager getting the sack. I think obviously that's come from the chairman witnessing obviously what happened.
Well, thank you for being so honest, and we appreciate you talking to about it. And obviously, next time we meet up, hopefully it'll be under better circumstances with the game like this. But obviously, everyone wants to hear what's happened. You know, you've given a good insight into what went on. So hopefully it gets sorted out as soon as possible.
Yeah, no problem.
And good luck for the next round of the Vars.
We always do a warm down after every game. We walked into the centre circle, and there was an altercation in the corner flag where, as you're walking into the change room. So me and Peter were talking to the referee, obviously, about that. The decision should have been a goal or sending off. But as it happens, just as we're getting talking to the referee, that's when the altercation happened, which then led to their change room, which then our lads went towards their change room. Peter will not condone what happened. I won't condone it. And obviously, the proof's in the pudding. The chairman won't condone it. The players have to take a lot of responsibility, because listen, when everyone kicks off in football, no one was more bad tempered. When I was playing, no one was more bad tempered than me. I would kick me granny if it meant winning a football game. But once that full time whistle goes, you shake hands, you're gonna have a pint with the team. That's as far as it should go. Every now and then you see little altercations, not just our level, but in the top level. That's at the heat of the moment. But what happened after the game, with the Newton Aycliffe lads going towards Morpeth's dressing room, should not have happened, which everyone knows that now. And I think people that were involved, they will regret it, because it's obviously Peter's sacrificed his own job because of the altercation. With me getting involved, I didn't get involved because I wanted to get involved. I got involved because
the right thing
it was
to do.
going to it was going to be someone was going to get seriously hurt, and our lads went to their dressing room, and I thought for the best interest is to get them out of the way as quick as I can. How I done it, I just got in there and tell them in the nicest possible way to get lost, because there's people in the motive change room who I've grouped with, I've played with. I've got a lot of time for Dave Maloney, got a lot of time for Nicky Gray. But listen, it's happened. It'll happen again at another level. It's unacceptable. The first thing Peter says when we went in the dressing room, he weren't happy with what had happened. He actually bollocked the lads. He didn't know the individuals, as he was probably the last one in there. What he did say was in the change room is, "Yous have started all that. Now watch the flack I'll get, because everyone will blame me." And as it happens, that's what happens. No one's mentioned certain players individually. They're all talking about Peter Dixon, which I think it's very, very unfair.
And obviously, this is a main gripe from your point of view. You don't think it's fair for a start, but his record as well. He's not a bad manager, is he? It's not
Peter's record's as good as anyone you'll see. He took over West Auckland. I think they won 5 points. He kept them up. He won a trophy with them in the first season. The two seasons after that, he got to the FA Vols final at Wembley. 2 seasons in a row. Albeit they got beat, but listen, they were there. He took over Newton Aycliffe, who was second or third bottom at the time. He kept them up. The second season, he finished sixth, which is the still greatest ever finish that they've had in the First Division. He also won a cup for them. They got to the quarter final of the FA Vols. This season, he's lost his job with a team that's joined fifth. We lost on penalties to Shildon, who were the champions of the other cup. And we've been beat on Saturday by last year's winners of the Vols. I mean, so anyone that says he's not going to get another job, I mean, who wouldn't want Peter Dixon as a manager? He's a top bloke, top manager. And what I will say about him, I've knew Peter for a lot of years, and I've had words with him in the past, as when I was managing Bedlington. He's a diamond of a bloke. He's a winner. He wants to win, and he'll do anything he can to win a game of football.
Well, thank you very much for your time. No, thank you for being so honest with me. And again, obviously the peacemaker, I think you might have a few job offers for that.
Well, that's it for this week's North East Football Show. I hope that we've given you as much information as possible and that everything was impartial, which is what we've tried to do, isn't it?
It is. It's, I have to say, our toughest show.
Yeah.
We've had to do more work. We've had more contacts than we've ever been given, but hopefully we've come across okay.
Yeah, I mean, it's something that we do want to do on the show. I mean, we do want to be giving people information, and you know, the Northern League itself is quite a close-knit group, and there's a lot of fans contacted us about this in the interviews we've done in the last couple of weeks, and everyone wants to see it. But again, you know, you can give us your reaction. Is the show going the right way for yourselves, or would you rather we're just spinning around with footballs?
I think you would rather spin around with footballs, providing it was a little bit warmer for you anyway.
Well, listen, what was the score, by the way, last week? Because I've never had a chance to actually mention this.
It's sort of been lost in what's happened. But Morpeth won 3-2.
Yeah.
The one thing that is disappointing is we've got Northern League clubs being drawn against each other again. And we've actually got the favourites, who were 3-1, by the way, really? South Shields, have been drawn at home against Morpeth at 8-1. It's a shame. I think once you get through to this round, I don't think it should be regionalised. We don't want Northern League clubs playing each other.
The funny thing is, I spoke to a lot of people this week before the draw, managers, chairmen, you know, not just from one club, from a lot of clubs, and they've all said the same thing: South Shields are going to get Morpeth. Now, if they're saying that, and then it comes up, it starts to look like it's sus, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, obviously it isn't, but it's just one of them things, and unfortunately we're going to lose one of the best teams that we've got from the league. But what I want to do touch on is Billingham Town from the second division.
Yeah,
have gone through to the next round. They had a great victory, so fantastic for them.
Well, listen, we've got an idea. Well, I say we. I've got an idea. He doesn't want anything to do with it. What we're going to do is we're going to put the fans out. Get involved.
Both of you.
Yeah, both. Each of you, get involved. We're going to try and get a petition to get the football show to get to the next draw of the FA Vars. I mean, there's no reason for not to. Listen, the show is massive now. International. So, TalkSport do it, Sky Sports do it. Why can't we do it? You know, get the cameras there, we'll watch the draw, everything's going to be fine, we can send it out, and then we'll all know who's getting drawn in the right way. There's no fuss about it. What do you reckon?
How do you think you'll cope being live, though?
You take ten takes
now.
That's just from here. Listen, we'll be fine. We'll be fine. As long as we're not allowed to swear still, you know what? We're all right. We're fine with this. But listen, anyway, all joking aside, I think it would be a good idea. You agree?
Yeah, we'll give it a go.
Yeah, we can only do our best. So you guys, we'll put something on Facebook or Twitter and get involved. Now, where can they see
you? You can see us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, and also...
Yeah, Friday, 7:30, only on Maidentown and Weir.